The Mahadasha planet will give you the status, the level at which you will play, basically. And whatever Antardashas you get in between, the Antardashas can either add to it or try to reduce it, but cannot do things which the Mahadasha Lord doesn't agree. So, for example, somebody suppose... let's take the example of marriage. So for somebody, if the Mahadasha Lord is denying marriage somehow, then it does not matter which Antardasha you are running. Even if you run planets of planet dasas of planets like Jupiter or Venus, situated in the second or seventh or 11th house, you will not get married. Why? Because the Mahadasha Lord has now told that my status is that I will follow celibacy. That's all. So now what happens? Suppose your Mahadasha Lord is saying you will not get married, and these Antardashas are keep coming for marriage. So then it's like saying you get too many proposals to get married, but somehow at the end the marriage doesn't happen. So and they also say Mahadasha is like the Atma, it is like the soul. And Antardasha is like the mind. And Pratyantar is like the body. And that is why we need to use the Pratyantar. So sometimes people say, oh, when will I get a promotion? So then now the promotion will happen first. How will you come to know about the promotion? Because Dasha means experience of something in life. So first is you will experience through the body. Body means you will get a phone call and your boss will tell you, hey, I'm giving you this promotion. So then your body has experienced. Then what happens immediately when we hear, our mind gets elated. We think, oh, at a mental level, we start feeling that. Then at a soul level, we will feel it. If the Mahadasha Lord is also agreeing for that. So now suppose the Antardasha Lord is not very much supportive of, you know, promotions or this kind of stuff in career matters. So then what happens? Now Pratyantars are very supportive. Let's take an example. Then what will happen is, even if you get the promotion, but you will not be happy inside. I mean, you will get some pleasure at a bodily level. You know, you'll get some more money or some allowances or some perks. Physically, you will get because that the promotion will give you. But at a mental level, you will feel, this is not worth it.
You might not like the extra burden that has come upon you. You might not be enjoying it or whatever.
Exactly. So at a mental level, it's like you have not got promotion. And so that is how it happens. And therefore, I have seen that if the Mahadasha Lord, and for Mahadasha, it's very difficult. People say that, oh, my Mahadasha Lord is, you know, this planet, it is sitting there, and what will happen in these 20 years? So the thing is, Mahadasha Lord talks about the Atma, basically. So therefore, it is very difficult if a person is not connected spiritually to oneself and to God or to his guru, at least his or her. The person has great difficulty in understanding what this Mahadasha is. I have seen it. You give them 100 answers, they will not be satisfied. Never. Because at a soul level, they only don't know what they are looking or what they should be looking for. Because suppose somebody runs, you know, Venus Mahadasha, let's take an example, 20 years. So you cannot tell him, you know, that, okay, after 3 years, you will have promotion. Then after 2 years, marriage. After 5 years, children. After 10 years, you will have a car. After 15 years, you will have an apartment. But the person will be like, okay, thank you for telling me that. But then... what is the difference between the previous Ketu Mahadasha and this Venus Mahadasha, and what will be the difference with Sun Mahadasha, which will come next? So to understand that, the person has to be connected to God at a spiritual level himself or herself. Otherwise, as an astrologer, it's very difficult because most of the astrology questions are pertaining to the Antar Dasha and Pratyantar. Most 99% of the questions. So one question is when will I get a job? When will I get a promotion, or when will I get married, or when will I find love, or this kind of, or when will I get a baby? So these are okay, money or job, that's like physical and to some extent mental, and you know, marriage, physical, and also relationship is more in the emotional part. So 99% of the questions are roaming around the Antardasa and the Pratyanta. And that is why if you try to observe, suppose somebody was running Venus Mahadasha, and then that person ran Mercury Antardasa. And after Mercury, he ran, suppose, Moon Pratyantar. So Venus, Mercury, Moon. No? Then now what you do, when his next Mahadasa starts, you try to analyze that same period. It's like Sun, Mercury, and Moon. Only Venus and Sun are different. Earlier it was Venus, now it's Sun. But you will see what the hell. Things are totally different. You know, although the questions are pertaining to the Antar and Pratyantar, but for the Mahadasha, if it is different, it is totally different. It's like there's no comparison. You check, you know, somebody was running Venus, Mercury, Moon, and then you check for Sun, Mercury, Moon. You cannot even compare. Of course, you can get some idea that, okay, maybe in this Antar Dasha and Pratyantar, some certain similar things will happen. But the end result is totally different, I've seen. It's like there is no comparison. Yeah. And another thing I have seen is the Mahadasha will tell you what kind, see, because ultimately what you do and what happens to you, or I would say what you do, is very much dependent on the people that you surround with. Very much. So I have seen this time and again, and I can almost confirm this, that the Mahadasha Lord tells you what kind of people you will hang out with. That changes the game altogether. Imagine, like, there was one lady who was telling me that she is very fearful to get married. So then I asked her, why are you so fearful? She said, actually, you know, my roommates, you know, they got married and later on they got divorced, and their husbands cheated on them, or, you know, some problem or the other happened. One person's husband left his body. So now what is happening? This lady, at a level of the soul, she's been surrounded by some people who are not directly but indirectly giving her a vibration that, oh, maybe if you get married, some similar things will happen with you. Now, that may happen or not, that's secondary. But you will feel that, oh, maybe I will also have a difficult married life, or maybe my husband will also pass, or anything like that. And because of that, what will happen? So now that is your, like, your Mahadasha. Then Antardasha is like, you know, you go to meet somebody, because Antardasha is the mind. So mentally you have to like somebody, you have to connect to somebody. Otherwise you generally don't marry the person. So then what will happen? Mentally you will have that program inside psychologically. Oh, maybe this person is also, you know, like that person, or maybe he's like that, she's like that. So then what will happen? You will not be able to decide mentally. Okay, should I go ahead with this person or that person? Whatever it is. And then if that only doesn't happen, then Pratyantar is like the final day of wedding. How will that happen? So you're on mute, I guess, madam.
Perfectly said.
Yeah, now let's take the example of the opposite. So suppose somebody's Mahadasha has changed. Somebody has gone to a very big company, like maybe Google or Microsoft. You know, people are like very much very positive, and they are always talking of new ideas. So now you are the same person. You don't change by going there. But what has happened, because you are in the company of those people, you also tend to behave like them after certain point of time. And then if your antardasha is supporting them, you will also start gaining ideas. Because now what is happening? If the antardasha is also supportive, it is supporting the mahadasha a lot. And if the pratyantara is also supportive, then you will not only think, you will also do practically. So when I see somebody is totally doing something new, then I know there has been a very strong change. I mean, something which he has never done before. That means his mahadasha has changed. And sometimes I see there are these great placements in the horoscope. You know, Dharma Karmadipati Yoga is there, or some Mahapurush Yoga or something is there. But it's like the yoga is sleeping.
Correct dasha at the correct time is very important. Activate these yogas or whatever is in the chart, to activate it.
Yes. So therefore, now why that is not becoming active? Because see, whichever Mahadasha you run, the Antara and Pratyantara will keep running always, of all the nine planets, in a span of 10 years, 15 years.
Whatever, so
if a person is of around 40 or 30, 35, so he's at the midway of his life, kind of. So it would have never happened that you have never gone through the antardasha of any one of the nine planets. And you have also experienced all pratyantars and their combinations of antar and pratyantar also. But because the Mahadasha Lord of your last 35 years did not agree to the agenda of these great yogas, so that yoga did not fructify. So it's like, it's very beautiful. It's like from the top, from the bottom it starts actually. And then from the top it descends. So it's like the Pratyantara Dasha Lord has an agenda. Then Antara Dasha has an agenda. Then he passes the request to the Mahadasha Lord. And then he's like, no, I deny this. I won't let this happen. So suppose the Mahadasha Lord is saying, you'll have a great married life. And the Antara Dasha says, no, your sixth house has got activity. And then Mahadasha Lord says, no, nothing doing. He will be married. That's all. Final. Now, you may not talk with each other, or you may stay separately and all blah, blah, but these things could be there, these things. But you will stay in the institution of marriage. That nobody can challenge.
Correct.
And the opposite is also true, if, as I said before. So, yeah, that is what... So, Vimshottari, I have seen regarding Mahadasha. So, people ask sometimes, okay, 15 years back, I was running the same Antardasha, but Mahadasha was different. So, how will you tell me what are the results, what difference will I find? So I tell them that yes, at a soul level you will feel like that. But then people ask me a counter question: what do you mean soul level? Because the 99%
difficult for them to understand, those who are not into astrology.
Yeah, so most of the people, they think, okay, one is the pratyantara. Okay, physically I am getting one person, I am touching, or I am, you know, hugging somebody, or I am getting some money, I am touching physically. Or mentally, I am getting some pleasure, you know, by talking to somebody, or, you know, getting some more money. I get mental pleasure also. So that's it. That's the end of life. Life is all about that. But the Mahadasha Lord actually tells you that you are not this body. You are spirit soul actually. Because that decides at how much happiness you will have ultimately in life. Because ultimately the body or the mind doesn't give happiness. The soul gives happiness ultimately. And when I say soul, I don't mean spiritually. But even at a mundane sense, the mind is not a living entity. The mind is a dead entity, which is like a servant of the soul. So when the soul, because ultimately the soul wants to experience something in this world through these objects. And mind is like the software, my guru used to say. Body is the hardware, mind is the software, soul is the user. But nowadays people think, you know, the mind is like the user, they think. So they think, okay, I want to drink wine. No, it's not you. Your mind is telling them. It is not that you are wanting to drink, you know, some mango juice or something. It is the mind which is telling. And then intelligence is the one which controls when it goes astray. So Vimshottari can be used at that level. Then we have the other dasa systems also. So one of them is Chala Dasa, which I use always during my consultations. So Chala Dasa, I have seen, Chala Dasa is a bit different, the way it functions in compared to Vimshottari. When I say different, I don't mean the calculation part. So Chala Dasa, as you all would know, it is a dasha of the sign. Okay. So it is like Chala
Mahadasa. The sign aspects and everything.
Yes, yes. So Chala Mahadasa is there, then Chala Antardasa is there. So that is very famous in the Jaimini tradition especially. And within that, I have seen for Chala Dasa, the planets give results as per the degrees. So for example, the planet with the least degree is known as Dharakaraka. And the planet bit above that is called Ganati Karaka. And the planet with the highest degree is known as Atma Karaka. So I have, whenever I use Chala Dasa, so and before discussing Chala Dasa, I would like to say, whichever dasa system you use, you see, these dasa systems are not fighting with each other. Sometimes people think, oh, my Vimshottari is telling this and my Chala Dasa is telling opposite. What will happen? No, it is not like that they will cut each other and nothing will happen in your life.
They all gel together.
Yes, so they are ultimately acting to give you the flavor which you are feeling ultimately.